Is squaring your hips and imagining that you're within two panes of glass in triangle pose or trikonasana a good and helpful cue?
This is a really good question, and it's a very common cue that we tend to hear in the yoga world, and it's one that's seen as pretty controversial. There are people who seem to think it's a really helpful cue, and then others who think it's a bad cue that we should not teach ever. So what's the deal with this cue, and why is it even offered? My understanding of the stay within two planes of glass cue is that the idea is that people are trying to encourage students to square their hips to the side so that their entire body is like lined up, like completely in that frontal plane. And then we hinge from this hip, keep everything squared, and we come in. And that's just the idea, the ideal for a triangle pose. That's like where that cue comes from. People who criticize this cue point out, and I think that this is an accurate thing to point out, but they point out that most people don't have the hip range of motion in the front hip in order to externally rotate the amount we need for triangle and to keep the pelvis completely square. Like, most people lack that range, so in order to come into the shape, the pelvis rotates forward a little bit to create that space in the front hip joint. And then we come forward. So the idea is that realistically in most human bodies, triangle looks a little more back hip rolled forward and not so much everything lined up between two planes of glass. So the people who criticize the cue, they think it's a bad cue because people can't embody it. And on top of that, people tend to claim that it's therefore an injurious cue. Because if you're in triangle pose and you try to roll this top hip back, the idea is that you create compression or pressure in this front hip joint, and you can end up like, the visual is that we're like shredding the tissues of the hip joint, like say the hip cartilage or labrum. So the idea is that it's injurious. So not only impossible to embody, but also injurious. So with all questions like this, I tend to try to take like a gray area approach. Like, there isn't really a black or white. And in general, I can see how most human bodies can't really embody that cue. So I wonder, like, is it helpful to try to encourage bodies to stay within two planes of glass if we can't? But I also wonder if it's actually injurious. Like, would I go that far as to suggest that that claim could be injurious? I thought Travis could share a few thoughts on that.
Yeah, so in that position, while it's true that full hip external rotation may not allow you to get your hips truly within two panes of glass, you are unlikely to damage yourself by trying to get into full hip external rotation. So, when we actively engage our muscles to get into any position, we can't get ourselves to that end range where it could be injurious. We can only get maybe 90% of the way there. So you're not actually going to hurt yourself. You may not get all the way into that position. So if your hip maybe was really rolled forward, then yeah, this could be a good cue to help align yourself a little bit more in this plane.
Them in that direction.
Right. And it's okay not to fully get there, and you're also not going to hurt yourself. So the one thing that maybe you would want to be mindful of is if you were doing an assist or getting an assist done to you, mm-hmm. where your teacher or someone was with you and helping you get into that position and being gentle with that assist, because you could imagine someone coming over and like really cranking on you and potentially getting you into your end range.
Do we want to show that assist really quickly?
Let's do it.
Okay. So just as an example of what you often see in yoga, someone is in or coming into their trikonasana pose, and then the teacher may notice that this person's top hip is like rolled forward, and if they think, oh, it should be between two planes of glass, they might come over and give this adjustment, one hand on the hip, one hand on the shoulder, and draw things back. So if this is done gently, I don't think Travis or I see a real means of injury here, and it can feel good. I like receiving this assist. But if a teacher were to do that really forcefully or aggressively, and maybe if that happened like over time repeatedly, then maybe like a super forceful rolling of the top hip could potentially be injurious. So maybe in that case, the idea of that cue might not be so helpful and potentially could be injurious. But in most realistic cases, especially if someone just in the pose and being cued to like roll the top hip back just to find the two planes of glass, that's most likely not going to be a mechanism for injury.
And it's just going to work those muscles of the that hip in an effective way.
That's the other thing. Like, it could be a positive thing because it helps. It helps train these front hip external rotators in a shortened position. And we often like that. We like to train our muscles in short and long ranges, and that's really effectively all that's doing. You're just actively engaging the muscles in that position, probably not injurious. So yeah, so all in all, it's probably not black or white. There's always a lot of nuance, and we just wanted to like take a look at this controversial cue and maybe open some minds around it. If you appreciated this content, subscribe to my channel so you can stay up to date on all the tips that we share.